Dolla Docta Jennifer here, and we are going back to the beginning, the sunroom. We are filming in the sunroom today because it's sunny out, and I had this stuff downstairs, and I didn't feel like dragging it all the way up to the office, I'll be honest. Got a new bin to put it in, so we got crazy. We went and bought the 10-pound Plush mystery box from Goodwill Bluebox. Why not? I mean, I've been looking at it for a while, and I was one Friday, I bought it and another 10 for 10 at the same time, and I was like, let's just do it and see what happens. I have looked in the box, I'm not gonna lie, already, because when I got it, I wanted to look in it right away because I'm one of those people. So it's not technically a mystery for me anymore, but I will show you what I got. I'm actually pleasantly surprised. It's a lot of stuff. So we have our little invoice. So the box is $19.99 plus $5 shipping plus tax. So it was around, I think, like $26-ish dollars total. $26.27. So I got all this for $27. I think, I mean, I don't know 100% because this is all kind of new to me, but I think we should be able to make money back at least, and probably profit. Even if stuff sells for really cheap, it'll add up because there are so many different ones. So I don't know a lot about the stuff, honestly, to begin with. So I am going to put somewhere comps after I look them up so that you can kind of get an idea of what stuff might sell for or what I'm hoping it's going to sell for. But again, you never know. So yeah, let us get into this haul. I am fairly excited. There are a couple I think I'm going to have to redonate just based on like quality, and some of them were looked a little dirty, and I'm not sure I'll really want to wash anything. But anyway, if you are new to this channel, welcome, and definitely subscribe if you enjoy this type of reseller content. This is definitely out of my comfort zone. Well, everything is technically out of my comfort zone. It's been a year whirlwind of fun, but I'm enjoying it and learning stuff. So anyway, subscribe, like this video, all that good stuff. Buy me a coffee if you feel so inclined to support my channel. And let's get into the Plush haul. So this is probably the worst type of haul I could get. I do have horrible dust mite allergies, and this box is probably just like literally a box of dust mites. I do have a tote that I am going to be putting them all in, so hopefully that will help. But yeah, when I first opened this box, I had a little trouble breathing for a minute. But this is Peekaboo Toys, lovable and huggable since 1995, and it's just a pink bear. I feel like something might be missing. It's a pink bear because there is this like string here that looks like it's been cut, so I don't know if something was like attached. Otherwise, this looks to be in really good condition. This you could sell like as a kid's toy, or even as possibly like a dog toy, for dogs that like plushes. It doesn't have like a squeaker or anything, but some dogs like to have like a plush. So we'll see what I will list this as. Like I said, I will put comp somewhere if I find anything. But my guess is this is not gonna go for a ton of money. Maybe $10 at most, probably less than that. This is the Beanie Buddies collection by Ty. I feel like I've heard these are going for some money right now. It looks kind of like it's a red dog. I don't have a name though, but this is from 1998. Someone put a black dot on the back, but this doesn't have a name. So if I find it, I will put the name in there. It doesn't have like any of the other tags, but it's in really good condition. It's just a red floppy-eared dog. I've heard this, the Beanie Buddies can do really well. So like I said, I will put in some comps for you. And I got like four of these different ones, but this is Cheer, the Care Bear, and this one is from 1983. It's Kenner is the brand. It's hard to see because someone, again, put marker on it. But I think it is 1983, made in Taiwan. There is some wear on the butt heart. Some of the lettering has come off, but overall, this looks to be in fairly good condition. Like all this looks good. It's got her little hair. And I mean, you can see that there's definitely wear in the eyeballs, but I think for a collector, someone would be interested in this. Doesn't look dirty that I can see right off. I mean, obviously it's from the 80s, so it does have some wear, but it's a Cheer Bear. Yay! And yeah, I did look up some comps on this one. I would say maybe like 10, 15, just depending on the condition. That's the word, condition. So we'll see. Like I said, I've got four. I think one is a different size, but I'm probably gonna list them all separately. And I will list them on Poshmark and probably on eBay as well. Here's another one. I think this one's a little bit smaller. It's got a little bit, ooh, its hair is a little crunchy. But it's got some wear in the eyeballs as well. The fur, but the heart actually looks a little bit nicer on this one. Like the words are still there. And this one is from 1983 Kenner. Care Bear TM collection, made in Mexico. Yeah, so this is just another one. That's the info, you can see it. Oops, it's upside down, my bad. So overall, this one looks pretty good as well. I think it is like slightly smaller than the other one. You can't really tell here, but I can tell. So that's two. I've got some more in here. Like this one is dirty. This one's either going to be a redonate or I'm just going to keep it myself. I think I'm just going to redonate it because it's a lot dirtier than I thought. It's a little rainbow giraffe though. It's also from Peekaboo Toys. It's got a hole in the neck. It looks like it had a hole here that got restitched, and it's got dirt and nastiness all over the back of it. So that's gonna be a redonate. Then we have a Pikachu. It's really cute. It looks to be in pretty good condition. A little of the stitching here, it looks a little loose, but it's still attached. Yeah, it needs a little bit of lint rolling. It's Pokemon. And it's from 2020. So it's newer. It's from manufacturer December 2019. And it's Pikachu. So that's cute. Pikachu! I did get some Christmas stuff, which could be good for people that like want to decorate for Christmas. So I should probably get these listed pretty quickly. This is, I'm not sure, let's see. Dandy International Limited, maybe? I don't know if you can see the tag at all. But it's a little penguin in a little like Christmas outfit. It does look to be in really good condition. This would be something like I feel like someone would put like on a shelf, part of Christmas decor. It's got little like candy canes, but then some of the candy canes are like little hearts. So that's really cute. Little like corduroy looking shirt. Just a fun little, this probably won't take get a whole lot, but I will look it up and see if I find anything exciting. This is another one that probably won't get a ton of money. And if you know anything about anything, definitely comment below and let me know, because I am open to information. This is Flomo, I think is the brand. Ooh, why can I not do this today? And it's just a pink bear with a bow. Nothing spectacular. Does have a hang tag, so I don't know if that means it's new or not. But I mean, this is like maybe a couple dollars. Nothing exciting. I may lot together some of the bears, like if they're just like a lot of bears. Stupid, I'm sorry. This is another tie. It's a kitty cat. I would probably keep this, but I feel like Beanie Babies, not the Beanie Buddies. This is, let's see, Starlet. And it does still have the tag, like the hang tag. So that's really nice. It looks like, it looks new. So hopefully I can get some good money for this one. There's something stuck in the hair. It's like some grass or something. Anyway, it looks pretty new. There's like a sticker or something in here. Anyway, kitty cat has a little plaid bow. It sits on its side and goes meow. Remy didn't like that. What? Meow, meow. Come here. Anyway, we'll see how much this will go for. Starlet the cat. We have this dog wearing a winter outfit in plaid. This is GT Gentle Treasures. No date on here. Why are these so hard to show? It's really cute though. It is a good season for it. So this would be a fun present for someone. It looks like it's in very good condition, that I can tell so far. And it's got a little hat. And yeah, it's really cute. So that'll be a fun one to list, and I will put, like I said, and keep saying, I will put comps somewhere if I find any. This is just, that's just the first part of the box, guys. Like, this is a legit, like, box of plush here. It's crazy. This is, well, I guess from 2016. It is a bear. It's got a little, maybe a little discoloration on the dress here, but It's a little Christmas bear. She's got ornaments on her dress. She's wearing some shiny leggings underneath. And I don't have a tag on her, so I'll have to figure out what she could be from what she looks like, because the tag is cut. But it's 2016 and she has a pretty, her outfit is pretty unique. So, and she looks like she's in pretty good condition. She's very soft. Cute little dress. There's a little bit of wear on her legs, but not too bad. Yeah, so, and this is a big one. Ugh. We have this monkey from Kohl's Cares. This is from 2013-2014. And it's just a monkey. Hello! yeah, probably not a ton. I'll look it up and see what I can find, but it looks like it's in pretty good condition, you know, for the most part. So, just a monkey. This is a lot. Let's see. This is, I don't know. Attico, maybe? I don't know. It doesn't have a good tag, like a good name brand tag. It does have this, though, so maybe I can scan it on eBay and see. But it's a bunny, like tie-dye bunny. It looks like it's missing the whiskers on one side. Or it's supposed to be like that, and it's broken. That's probably it. So, but otherwise, it looks like it's in pretty good condition. It's, doesn't look dirty at all or anything. So, I mean, it probably won't go for a ton, but it's cute. This one, I don't know. It might be a redonate. Its hair is kind of rough looking. Maybe it's supposed to be like that. I'll have to look it up. But it's Scruffin' Loves. It's got like a little cup. 2018. It's just like, I don't know if it's supposed to be a dog or a bunny or what it is exactly. It's got these ginormous eyes underneath, but you can't hardly see them because the hair is so messed up. And it's got like pink and purple with like glitter in it. Yeah. I don't know. I'll have to look that one up. It's not dirty, but it's looks a little rough. This is Goffa International Corp. G-O-F-F-A. And it's just a tiny little teddy bear. So this might go in that quote unquote teddy bear lot if I make one. I mean, it looks like it's in good condition. It's had some wear, but not a ton. And yeah, it's just a tiny teddy bear. Nothing crazy. Here's another cheer bear. And this one's a little different. This one has pink around the eyes. The other ones had like a cream color. This one has a little flaw on the rainbow, and the heart is also a little worn. I think this one is also from 83. Yeah, this one's also from 1983. I think they're all 83. So this one has a little bit more wear to it than the other ones so far. So it probably won't get as much, although I have to figure out the whole like eyelash situation, like color wise. I wonder if this is a rarer color or if the other ones are. I don't know. I don't know anything about this stuff yet. Have to look it up and figure it out. And if you know stuff, definitely, definitely send me some info. Cause I need help. I'll just do the last one. One more. Cheer Bear. This one also has some wear to it. Down here. And then the nose is a little worn. This has some issues. And this is also, let's see. This is also from 83 though. They're all, and this one actually has some stains on it. So this one probably won't go for very much. I'll have to see if I'm gonna sell it or not. Or if I just might re-donate it. Or I'll just price it really low and hopefully someone will take it off my hands. Then we have this amazing floral dolphin. I love this, it's really cute. It's Fiesta, 14 inch pick me dolphin. And let's see. That's all I got. But it's in really good condition. You don't see any issues. And it's a really fun print, so I'll definitely look this up. But this is one that I would think about keeping myself because it's fun colors and it's cute for a display, not for anything else. This box has been very hard to keep away from Remy. He keeps being like, what's in there? I'm like, that's not for you. All right, my tote is getting full. Here's another Christmas. This is Dandy, Collector's Choice. From 2012. And it's just a cute little Christmas dog. It's got little boots on. It does still have hang tags. I don't know if that means it's new or whatnot, but it's a cute little dog. Christmas, again, like a Christmas decor type situation. It also has like around the ear, so I don't know if it's missing something, but I'll just disclose it in the thing. This is another one I think I'm going to redonate. It doesn't have any tags, but I feel like it's Pokemon related. I'll have to look it up and see. But it's really rough shape. So if I think anyone's interested in this, if you want to pay for shipping, I'll send it to you. If you're into this whatever this is. It just like looks rough. It's hard to see honestly in here, but it looks rough. So I probably won't resell this one. I'll probably either donate it or if someone wants it, they can have it. Another Pokemon. This is from 2016 as well. This needs some cleanup. And I'm gonna be honest, I forget what this one's called. But here it is. And it's got a little bit of wear. It has like a little hang thing though. You can hang it somewhere if you want. It's got some little stuff that needs to be sweater shaved underneath there. Overall, it looks like it doesn't look stained or anything. It does have a lot of hair on it that needs to be lint rolled, but Pokemon, what are you two doing? This I want to keep myself. It's a sloth. It has nothing else, but it has like arms that go in so you can it can be your friend. And you can wear it. So who doesn't want a sloth friend on their arm? It's really cute. So yeah, that's fun. And it's in excellent condition. Another Christmas one. It's a little rougher looking. This is Fiesta as well. 12 inch Santa's Secret Elf. And it's, let's see. That's all I got. Oh, Fiesta tag again. So yeah, it's just a little elf. It does have some discoloration, so I may just redonate this because it doesn't look that great. Her face is dirty, and then she's got some dirt on the sleeve and on her neck, and it's just not worth it to do anything with that. I think this one, is this a redonate too? No. Maybe. This is Disney. Oh, that's right. It's Disney, but I don't really, it's a cow. But we've got like some staining and stuff. Yeah, I don't know. This might be a redonate as well. Or just make a huge lot of things. So, anyway, yeah, it's got like stains all over. Not great. This is, I don't know. No brand that I can see. It's a little like poodly dog. Looks like it's in pretty good condition. It's got very fuzzy hair and a little tail. It has a tag, but it doesn't have a brand. So it might go in a lot of something. And lastly, an interesting one. This is a bear, pretty big bear. He's wearing a plaid shirt and pants. It didn't really look like anything until I looked at the bottom of one of his shoes. And it says, heirloom, is it heirloom? I think it's heirloom. Coca-Cola collectibles. I don't know if you'll be able to see that, probably not. So I need to do some research on this one as well. He does have like a movable head. He's in really good condition. Those little shoes. So I don't understand why it's Coca-Cola collectible, but we'll see what we can find out and go from there. So anyway, that is everything from my plush box. Definitely comment below how you think it went, if I can make my money back. I think I can. Like I said, some of them won't sell for much, but it's like a quantity versus quality. There are some quality in there, but there's also some that are just teddy bears. They're not really like anything fantastic, but you know, there's a couple, you know, that aren't salvageable really. So that's three out of however many are in here. I don't know how many. So let me count real quick, and then I'll let you know about the average price per one. And yeah, we'll see how that goes. Be right back. So it looks like you got about 26 plush, which makes them about a dollar each. So that's not too bad. I definitely thought it was gonna be a lot more per item than that. So, well, with three getting tossed, probably it's a little bit more than that. But in general, like, that's not a bad cost of goods for some of these plush. Especially the tie, I'll really have to look those up and see how much they are worth. But I am happy with this box. I got real excited. So this is a new avenue. I will definitely circle back around in a couple months and let you know how we did. And yeah, we'll go from there. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Remember to subscribe and remember to help control the pet population and have your pets spayed or neutered. Bye guys.